Now, I know it doesn't look like it, but I want to be healthier. That's my goal. I'm giving it the old 3-week try. My friend bought me a Fitbit. I don't have the energy to put it on, so that's not good. I'm like, I'm not walking 10,000 steps unless it's to a bakery. That's it. So it defeats the purpose. I love cake. That's my vice. That's probably why I was a virgin for a long time. Any virgins in here? All right, cool. Cool. Yeah, I was a virgin for a long time. Like Judd Apatow could have written a movie about me. Big virgin in college, and like people thought that was weird, but I'm from the South, so I could use religious reasons for being a virgin. I was like, I am a virgin for Jesus. I am doing this for Jesus. And Jesus was like, I don't think you are, though. Nope. That's on you. You might want to wear that Fitbit. Jesus! Oh, thou shalt not judge, Jesus. But I'd still go out to the club with my friends who are not virgins. And they're like, we would have a girls' night, and there's always like one girl in every girls' night group who is the responsible one, the chubby one. And if she's not having sex, she does not want her friends to have sex. Like, and I was that girl. I was that one just walking into the club, just swatting penises away. Like, poof, not on my watch. Poof. 2 a.m. would hit, and like, you know, the guys that were hanging out with my friends thought they were getting lucky, and I would be like, you guys, let's go. Christina, you're better than this. Let's go. Jessica, you need to respect yourself. Let's go. Do you remember what happened to Rebecca? Neither does she. Let's go. You said we were gonna go to IHOP at the end of the night. Let's go. Is the worst. Turns out I was a virgin because I was a lesbian and nobody told me. I had no idea. And like I said, I was still in the closet in college. I moved in with a guy friend of mine, and my mom, being the good Christian woman that she was not having it. She's like, I cannot believe that you're moving in with a man and you're not even married. You're going to be living in sin. I was like, well, then you're really not going to like the next thing I have to tell you. Buckle up, we's about to get on the gay train. Ooh-hoo! That was a gay train. Thank you. Who doesn't love a nice gay train? And so I finally realized that I was gay, and I had to tell my dad, which was like really nerve-wracking because he doesn't like to have these deep conversations. So I was like, Dad, I gotta tell you, I'm gay. And he was just like, okay. Okay. Well, do you want to go buy you like a men's blazer or a top hat? I was like, do you think lesbians wear top hats? He's like, I don't know. I'm trying to connect the dots. Turns out I learned everything I needed to know about being a lesbian in high school. We had a sex ed class for lesbians. It was called Woodshop. Very handy class. Very handy. I still got it with the dudes, though. I got hit on by a guy, which hasn't happened since never. I was leaving my friend's house, and I was standing there on this corner, and this guy comes up to me. He's like, hey, do you want to go back to my house with me? And I was like, me? He was like, yeah. I was like, dude, I'm wearing a top hat. Yeah. That should be your first clue that this is not gonna work out. And I was like, and besides, that's not how you talk to a lady such as myself. He was like, lady? I thought you were my friend Craig. Oh, I was so offended until he showed me a picture of his friend Craig. It turned out we were total twinsies. Thank you guys so much.